Echt dik?
The question presented to us is, if you're given the opportunity in your next job to go to China, what types of support programs would you expect or ask for? So, almost majority of us are exchange students here in Taiwan. So most probably you will experience the same thing when you walk into China or when you walk into another country that is not familiar to you. So these are the possible programs that you could ask for if you walk into another country. One, language courses. Although people might know English, it's still better if you know the language of the locals. For example, here in Taiwan, you cannot talk to everyone in English. Like, there would be some people who wouldn't understand English, or there would be some people who might understand you, but they are not confident to speak English. So you have to talk to them in Chinese. So recommended is at least 1 month training. So since you're already a professional, you might as well be used to learning languages and cultures. So 1 month could be enough for you to learn the language of the local. Next.
The company should provide a cultural-related seminar, which you should attend to just get some cultural awareness in terms of communication. For example, the direct versus the indirect communication, so that you just have a feeling for the people, why they do this and how they do it and what's the difference, and just that you have an idea of what you could face in a new country.
Yeah, and then the third one is a contact database. So if you're foreign in a country, you would want to know the certain important numbers that you might need if ever you would have an emergency or something. For example, if you would be sick or you encountered an accident or someone robbed you or something, you would need the police number, the hospital number, but more than that, you might need the immigration number and stuff like that. So you would need some database for you to be able to have a ready number just in case any emergency happens.
Yeah, the company should assist you in terms of transportation, which means they should provide you with a visa to go to China. They should arrange flights, maybe also during your stay, so that you can go home like once or twice a year, that you just can visit your home, your family, your friends. And maybe they could arrange a car to get around there, or a scooter, or whatever, depends on where you're going, what you need there.
Yeah, and then since you are new to the country, you also want to ask for accommodation, like for the company to provide you a dorm and apartment, and to make your life easier than you finding your own apartment. Since technically it was the company who sends you to China, so it is their responsibility to provide you living conditions, like good living conditions.
And if they want to send, for example, a father or a mother of a family, they might provide or might tell you where you can send your children to kindergarten.
Yeah, very important.
Or arrange an apartment near kindergarten, near school, so that they don't have a far way to go, or just that you can take your family with you.
Yeah.
And then lastly, I think, since you will be going out of the country, you might have, say, 2 years or 3 years in another country. So when you get back, you might be culture shock again with your own culture, like with what you were used to. So also, since you're leaving your job in your country, you're taking a job in another's country, the company must secure you a job when you return the your home country, because usually some people might build their career in another country, but when they go back to their home country, they have nothing because it's been a while since they left the country. Alright, so that's all for the presentation.
Very good. Yeah. You ask a lot, huh? Or most of them for the living support.
like everyone here, we're going to talk about how to make attractive actually like a job abroad for like an expatriate. So first there was like the pre-departure training, and then there was like 1 year abroad training. So under pre-departure training, you actually have first of all to know what country you're going to deal with. So having a cultural awareness training. So we are talking here about sending managers abroad, not like every single employee, because we are in human resources management. So training for managers, it's first you have to know which culture behavior you are going to deal with. So you are going to train other people abroad, you are going to give orders to other people abroad all the time. So when you're going to talk with Mexican people or talk with Chinese people or talk with French people, most of the time it's won't be the same. Like you have to know how to deal with and how to manage them, lead them and everything. So then you're going to train about how to adapt to the country for yourself, of course, because for example, just the food. How are you going to know about the food if you're not speaking the language, like in China, and how are you going to know where to find the project you want and everything, so you just have to know about the country, the basics one, of course, at the beginning. And then you're going to have lectures about the culture, that's mean like local people coming and explaining to you what's going on and everything, or all the testimony from expatriates, all the expatriate people that you can use to use for all they deal with at the beginning and just explaining what you should do and what you should not do and like just giving advice. Then the company should provide preliminary visits. That means like it's good to hear about what you have in the country, but it's even better to see what's in the country more than 1 week. Like if you know what's in the country, you're not just going like blind, you just know what you're going to see and where you're going to live, so you can just prepare yourself after because you already know. Of course, there is a language skill training, but it's not the most important one because most of the time you just have to speak English. Some companies won't speak English, and in this case, you should just have a really, really intensive language skill training. But most of the time, if you just can deal with English, you can, of course, doing business abroad like an expatriate. And finally, practical assistance. It's like transportation assistance and like visa preparation and finding some people over there just to help you when you're going to get there. And like the person just going to welcome you when you're going to be at the airport. Most of this is like practical, really, on the moment.
You're very prudent.
Then like we found a model for cultural awareness training. So that's most of the models we found are always the same, the kind of same, so three dimensions. First, you're going to talk about it, then you're going to know how you feel about it and how you should deal with it. And then before going abroad, you're going to have like practical training, like an immersion approach. You're going to try it and you're going to have like role game or even study case and know what you should do and what you should not do. And then you can discuss about what you did and what you should have done. So that's more practical and you're not just going and trying and once you're abroad.
Yeah.
And while you're abroad, you need support from your own organization. And the basic one is just the financials, like the base salary from your organization that you can stay in the same living standards as back home. Plus that you might get some bonus just being abroad. And of course your organization has to support you. Also by like mine, that you, if you feel like feeling homesick or feeling that you're not really dealing with the right person, so they have to give you support. And also support your family and your living, so they have to give you housing and support your children's education and maybe kindergarten and your wife. Maybe they also give some money or salary to your wife to use. And then of course possibility to visit home. As many times you want, or they have a time limit to that. Of course, benefits like insurance and healthcare and other social benefits. Maintain the communication with your home organization, your parent company. So that when you get back, so you know what's happening in your organization, that maybe you can avoid the culture shock when you get back.
Very good. Yeah. So Peter, huh? Wonderful.
has not only to introduce the country, but also have this program where they send a bunch of potential candidates to overseas just to in China to stay for around like probably 2 weeks. So you really get to experience their culture, to see whether their food is acceptable, is it to your liking. And then from there, then those who really stay at the end of, till the end of the project will really decide, okay, yeah, they know that they can pick the 2-year assignments, then the company send them abroad. Because company usually sends foreigners abroad for long assignments, and usually if they are not able to adapt well to the country, they will ask to leave like 3 months later or 6 months later. And it's really caused by the company of bonds to send them abroad. So if the assignment was cut short, the company is really losing a lot of money. So next, as said by the previous group, is to have basic Chinese lessons. And they also, it's also important for the company, for HR, to brief them about their career development. So if I return back from the foreign land, from China's back market country, will I get promoted or will I still get the same machine job? Or I don't even get a job at all. So I need to know them well before I even leave you. I also need to know my reimbursement package. So the important criteria is that the medical insurance, my apartment, whether it will be subsidized by the company or do I need to solve it myself. If I have a spouse, what about my allowance? Do they give them allowance or do they provide jobs for their spouse? My insurance, where do my insurance studies? Do I get allowance if I go to international school? Because from what I know, my friend told me that he sent his children to Singapore for education and an international school costs a bomb. It literally costs about 1/3 of the salaries. So, and I also need occasional leave for family visits, as in fly back to my home country to visit my parents, etc. And lastly, the assistance for legal procedures such as the visa when I try to apply to China. From a few years back, I heard that it's really complicated to try to apply visa for China. They ask a lot of stuff. So I don't know what's the situation right now.
Okay, so during the stay in China, firstly, we'll look at hoping to have an orientation of welcome program in China so that you get to know the colleagues that you're working with and also the culture that you're in for the company as well as the country. Secondly, we're also looking at having a local buddy system such that the person can actually bring you around China and introduce you to what the whole China culture is about, and as well as an experienced chauffeur, because driving in China is actually very dangerous, and let's say you do not have the experience, it's actually not very good for you. Yeah. Other than that, we're also thinking of organizing like support group for foreigners in China, as well as also like professional counseling to overcome like cultural differences. Because let's say firstly you work there, then you are a manager, but you felt that like the people around you, they are not actually listening to you because of the difference in culture, then you are feeling very stressed. You need some form of professional counseling. So this is like a support program that is designed for you if the need arises. And lastly is the performance evaluation, because you actually need to talk to your host company about what should my performance standard be such that you will be sending me overseas and how should I perform over there. So these are all very important. Yeah.
Very good. Yeah. Very important for this, all this post. Yeah, this is for the working support program, and some social support. Important. Yeah, very good.
So for the question, if you are given the opportunity to go work in China, what types of support programs do you expect or ask for? Especially, we're asking for accommodation, of course, like house or apartment, and the transportation from the airport to the accommodation, but also in the town, around the town, and also the relocation allowance. Secondly, they ask for Chinese trainings, of course, because it's important to they work with Chinese. Important to have budgets in Chinese, and also to live in the town is important to have budgets.
The company can also organize a seminar about how to live in China, because they can know their life habits, for example, how to buy everything, and it can be also how to find, I don't know, a good babysitter, to can be everything about their day life. We can also provide education elements for the children, so to find a good school near to their workplace, or to find school which provide different language courses.
Yeah.
And for people's the trip in China, people can ask for advice about paperwork like insurance, visa, and bank accounts.
Yeah, all these the living, right?
Yeah.
The living support, very good.
And the company can help to find expert contacts. It's important because the foreigner would like to have some contacts from the same country as the
suggestion. Very, very practical. Yeah. Very practical. So if you are the CEO, right, in China, yeah, think about this, right? Always organize this kind of the free trip for your expatriate manager. Yeah, they then can know the real situation of China. Yeah, wonderful. Next. Okay.
Okay, so I'm with Rupo, and these are some
please my comments. Yeah, you got it.
Okay, so these are some aspects we will expect from the HR department. And there are two parts of it. First one is working environment, second one is living environment. So first, we hope that we can have an environment where the politics and the politics are stable, and there will be less criminal events, because, you know, if you work on, in some regions in China, if you walk on the street, you may be bumped, or be if you are a female, maybe you will meet someone very strange, so you might need some protection to protect yourself. For example, you might have a safety guard staying in your company or in the department you live in. And second one is friendly and professional environment. This is when a foreigner works in the office, and the people there may not be so friendly to you, but they still have to understand that because you are even if you don't like each other, but because you work in the same working place, and you have to. Even if you have quarrels outside and you have to fight outside, but if you step in the office, you have to understand that you have to work together and you have to do your job together, and this is important and very professional. And the third one is clean office, and it's important for some people because if their working place is not clean, then they cannot work very efficiently, and they can be one staff cleaning the office every day, or depends on the needs of the person. And fourth, high technology. For example, you might need a computer or good telecom devices to communicate with your other steps or other companies. And the fifth one, health protecting.
You mean the infrastructure, right? Infrastructure. Provide the very good infrastructure for your job that you are working. Right?
Yes, and you can communicate anytime you want. And health protecting methods. And we know that in some industrial regions in China, they have very serious air pollution. So we hope that we can get some protection, medical support or something like hip body examination every year to help us prevent getting some cancers or illness from air pollution. Okay. And the sixth one, multicultural society, and this is especially important for people, for foreigners, because if when a foreigner stay in a company where most of the staffs are local, and they might receive some discrimination. So if you can have a multicultural society, this can make people there work more friendly and more efficient for foreigner workers. Okay, so the second part is living conditions and some personal expectations, and safety social condition. And just as I mentioned last page, we might need a safety guard in your living apartment.
And can you talk more about a personal consultant? Okay, the personal consultant.
Personal consultant.
Yeah, okay.
Personal consultant is like when you move to a new environment and you might not understand the culture very well, so you might need a person to teach you things about the culture, and this consultant is sort of like a psychologist or a personal psychologist, and maybe you have problems or you want to consult, you want to help in, you have something private in your mind, and you have someone to talk to.
So this is for individual need or for working need?
Individual.
Individual, okay.
Okay. So I finished the...
Okay. I think that all the other items given by other group in detail, that's it. Okay. But the base page is the personal consultant. Okay. Yeah, thank you. Any other? Any more?
I think health insurance is important because if you don't have health insurance, then you might pay very expensive money to go to the hospital.
Yeah. Okay.
So basically, this is.
Thank you. Yeah. Good. Thank you. Next.
My name is Lina, and today we are going to talk about the issue. If I have an opportunity to go to China, and what types of supporting programs are expected? Because I think housing is very important, because if I am somewhere and I don't have friends or any relatives there, so I will need behalf, and if happily, maybe he can help me to find a good environment to learn there, and the second, the language training. And because Chinese is my mother language, so I don't need it. But for some foreigner, it's necessary before they're leaving their home country. They have to learn some Chinese, so it will be more convenient for them when they're living in China. And third is diversity training. And I think it's also very important because I think China in a Western land, very different culture. So for example, the table manners were different. And people do the business and they are different. They are in different ways. For example, Chinese people, they take guanxi very important. And some social skills. And next is the ear bonus is necessary. And before you check this opportunity, you have to make a deal with the company. And next one is the traffic expenses. So I think it depends on the position, because some people, company will provide the car and driver, and some people, maybe the office only offer them the MRT tickets, only one round trip ticket or some local transportation. And next is the trauma support. If I work in China alone, and there's no my friend, no my relative, then I will miss them. So I need, maybe sometimes I feel upset, I will need someone to talk. And maybe the company, they can offer me this kind of support. And insurance, it's very important if I have any access, if I'm sick or I have any accident, I will need insurance. So next is the VIP session, especially medical care. Take my friend as an example. He was still working in China, and 1 year he had a tooth ache, and when he go to the public hospital, then the doctor gave him too much medicine because he had
foot down by.
Okay.
So,
kidney,
so it's a very serious illness. So like he had to come back to Taiwan and have an operation and translate for half hour. And next one is the translation assistant. I think it's also necessary for foreigner, but not for me. Prepare training for any job skills like what they need. For example, the marketing research or any support they need. Next is some details. For example, visa supporting, bank accounting, and cell phone. So that's what I think.
Cost a lot, huh? Financial support. Okay, thank you. Yeah. Last. Okay.
Good morning, I'm Julia. I'm from the country. If you are people with disability in your next door in China, what type of support program should you expect to ask for? And just we think training is very important, and not only before we go to China, and also in Alaska, and we should give them some cultural training and let them know how to adapt or let them know about the local habits. And the second is language. Maybe you would think language is not a
you will not easily work with you And the third is working method. We think we should let the company should let the employees know how to manage their job in China or how to work with the others. And welcoming, if we come to work in China, we would prefer the company are very nice and take care of you. Maybe they can...
Mentor? You mean the supervisor or mentor? Supervisor?
Yeah.
Okay.
Have a supervisor who can lead you and maybe like an assistant and maybe buddy, like some give you some giving support.
I think many items have been mentioned by our group, but how about the promotion?
If you take this chance to work in China, you in the future you have
the career, right? The career development.
Even if you come back to your home country and you have the chance to
go
on your career.
Yeah, this very good can answer the question, why China, right? If China is very important, then after I return, you know, maybe I got promoted to handle the more important job, right? Thank you. Right? Finish? Any other? No? No, okay, good, thank you, yeah. Very wonderful presentation by you. You consider a lot and ask for more. Okay, ask more and your successful opportunity will be more. Thank you for your participation.